Welcome back to SOK, Soviet Union Knowledge for All. My name is Dmitry Dmitriev, and this is This is you. November 1, 1957. Let this day go down in history. The rocket ship Sputnik 8K71PS launched into space, but not alone. A dog named Laika was also in the rocket, which was launched on October 4. Laika is a mostly Siberian husky and was rescued from the streets of Moscow. She was trained in special laboratory especially for this trip. Dr. William Lane Peter, director of the Laboratory Animals Bureau of the Medical Research Council, confirmed that she was practically born for the mission. In an interview, this dog would have been trained long for the task and subjected to similar simulated conditions. And this flight is just another experience of the same sort.
True enough, she was successfully orbited the Earth. It is truly something to be proud of. This success is a turning point of the race to space, although the winner will obviously be us. It simply proves that we are a better country than the US and shows how much success the communist way of life can bring our nation. The American capitalists cannot even dream of beating us. In their capitalist society, they are all competing against one another, unlike the great communist Soviet Union. Here, we work together for the greater good. Based on our accomplishment, this proves that working together the communist way gets the job done. This progression of the race has put communism above all other forms of government, and the rest of Europe will follow in our footsteps. Let us all be forever united and faithful.
In other news, Operation Plum Bob, a nuclear test bomb in US has gone wrong.
Of course.
Our nuclear testing is going much better.
Not to forget another celebration for our SU. In November, the third Soviet Antarctic expedition has arrived in Antarctica.
As well, you can now get commemorative Laika post stamps. Good night, RIP Papa Stalin. And long live our great leader Nikita Khrushchev. Thank you, Svetlana. And now, on to the news. Welcome back to SOKA, Soviet Union Knowledge for All. My name is Dmitry Dmitriev, and this
and
is
my name is Luda.
This is Luda. Let's get rushing into this news. Have you heard about the new addition to Germany's architecture?
Yes, I have, Dmitry, but we are on television, so you have to tell me anyway.
Well, it is all the buzz right now. We all know about the tensions between East and West Germany, of course. Now it looks like the East Germany has decided to take things into her own hands. Construction on the Berlin Wall has begun, blocking up one's ability to cross over that particular border.
Oh yes, Dmitry, and it is good. This wall is being built to protect the citizens from the crazy Americans and their capitalism. Mm-hmm. East Germany is much better off without the dangerous and ridiculous Western influences. But Dmitry, of course, you will mention the impressive comment from the American president.
Of course. That means the attempt to assure Western Berliners of the continued support from the US. Putus Kennedy traveled to the Berlin Wall.
What a waste of American dollars!
And started yelling, Ich bin ein Berliner!
But my Dmitry, what does this mean?
I am so happy you asked. Funny enough, the word Berliner is a slang term for jelly donut. In most of Germany, so out of context, the president of the glorious United States was proclaiming that he was a jelly donut.
Oh, how humiliating! Isn't this freedom of expression? Well, ladies and gentlemen of the Soviet Union, this is what happens when capitalists start to think for themselves. Pure embarrassment.
In other news, the black market is now selling denim jeans. Get them while they're hot. But remember, they are illegal here, so don't let the KGB catch you. Luda, don't you have a pair?
Yes, I do. They make my bottom look like an angel.
Oh.
Good night, eat some jelly donuts, and long live our great leader Nikita Khrushchev.
Welcome back to SOKA, Soviet Union Knowledge for All. My name is Dmitry Dmitriev, and this is Luda. Oh, Luda, what do you have there?
Oh, this? It's my Tsarbucks.
Anyway, tonight we bring you a steamy piece of news. Headlines read, Russia says niet to the Los Angeles of Olympics.
Why, you ask? What are the reasons for this scandal? Well, here at SOKA we have all the information, and we are leaning towards telling you.
Puns don't get you any extra marks, you know.
Ah, Soviet!
Here's the deal. In 1980, former president of America decided to boycott the Olympics that were held here in Moscow. the only US-led boycott of the Olympics in history.
How petty. I cannot imagine a reason why they would do this.
Well, actually, it was because of the disagreement that...
If our athletes did go to Los Angeles, they would be bombarded with protests and possible physical attacks. We are all aware of the negative freedoms, such as freedom from tyranny that the capitalists claim to have.
Negative freedoms haven't made any sense.
I know, and yet here we are. But there is no saying what they would do to us two humble communists when we would step onto their land. They see us as a threat, you know.
Indeed. This decision to not attend the Olympics has nothing to do with the boycott a couple years ago. It is purely in pursuit of the safety and well-being of our athletes.
As well, so far, 13 other Soviet countries have also decided to boycott the Olympics, following Russia's steps. What a good example we give. However, what might this mean for the outcomes of the games?
There's no way of telling, but the world is aware of the talents of Soviet athletes. Without this competition, it is sure to be a boring watch.
Well, there you have it. If you have any questions, please tune in to our newscast tomorrow morning, where we will have experts on the topic. Good night, and long live our leader, Yuri Andropov.
And coming up after the break, the addicting new game, Tetris.